Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we're going to do a room called Android Malware Analysis. So let's click on complete and move on to task 2, which is our first steps. So most Android malware masquerades as a normal application. Those files are called APKs, Android Application Packages, and almost majority of the Android applications are APKs. So now we have, because Google Play adds some information to the APKs when they are uploaded to the Play Store, it is possible to check for applications that come from it. So the process of adding information is called frosting. When you find an APK that is not frosted, you would need to be extra careful with it. There are chances it can be malicious. So this is the case study. Let's open it in other tab, and during the next steps we are going to use PipHus, an open source online static analysis tool. And PipHus embeds a number of tools that you might have seen in the previous room, such as this. You will work on the following sample. So click on here and open this link as well. So what is the name of the technique used by Google Play to mark applications uploaded to the Play Store? It's frosting. So what is the name of the package? So let's see. I guess the name of the package is com.wire. Click here. What is the MD5 hash of the APK? MD5 hash is here, files in file sums. Copy it from here, paste it here. What is the SHA-256 hash of the this sample? It is right here. Copy it and paste it here. What is the size of the sample? So I guess it is 40.68 MB. Okay, click here. Complete. So that completes our task 2. So let's move on to task 3, which is, in this we will see the APK analysis, and we can find that that this version was released on March 1, 2021. So in the threat intel tab, you have a timeline of events that could tell us about the malware, time when the malware was active or it is supposed to be active. So threat intel, this is here. So it was valid before this certificate, was not valid before this, and will be not, its expiry date is on 2048. So let's move on. We can see the X5509 certificate was created to work from this, and this is the oldest files from the samples were identified around the time 2 months after the release of the version of this legit APK. So we have activities, and we have some behavior analysis. We'll gather some general information on how the APK is behaving. The first part of the tab looks like the permissions the APK will be requesting. So write SMS, write settings. So in threat analysis, we have to, with these tools, it is possible to identify a number of primes. So, and at the last, we have behavior analysis, modifying behavior. Here we can see the name of the classes that we have identified behaviors, which will give us valuable pivot points when analyzing the APK. So in, at the last, we have network analysis tab, from which we can see a number of domains that have been identified are cured by the APK. So let's start answering the questions. So what version of the application is targeted? Okay, so it's this 3.65.979. Click here, paste it here. Check all the activities. There is one standing on. Which one is that? So let's check for activities. Activities, manifest analysis. And we have some activities. That is okay. We have this start version activities, launch activities, and going up we have this manifest analysis, which has app has a network configuration, this org.xml push.sv.services. We have receive main, we have start version here, which is rated high, and activity is found to be shared with the other apps on the device, therefore leaving it accessible to other applications. It is also the same with activity should where is it? The presence of intent filter indicates that it is that the broadcast receiver is explicitly exported. Okay. So we have this XML push.s3.start version, and we have an activity should not. This main activity is also the same, and activity is found to be shared with other apps on the device, therefore leaving it accessible to other applications. The same as this start version line, the presence of intent filter, and we can see that the option is 4. So we are looking for the activity which is divided into 4. So let's go here and see. We can see that this org.xmlpush.version3.start version is of 4, and launch activities are also 4. So let's try this, because it looks kind of similar and repetitive here. We can see that an activity is found to be shared with other apps here, and it was the same for, maybe I am wrong, but that's how I thought this was. And how many activities in the manifest analysis are linked to the activities? So basically there are 3 activities I can show you, which is this start version, an activity is found to be shared with other apps, and an activity is found to be shared with other apps on the device before leaving. So we have 2, and a last one is an activity is found to be shared with other apps, the presence of intent filter. So basically we have found 3 activities. What is the first crime? What is the first crime identified? So for the crimes, we have to go to a bit up here, and we can see that under threat analysis are the crimes. So let's go to threat analysis. Okay, where is threat analysis? So threat analysis, this is the load external class, which was the first crime. Click on here, answer this question. What is the crime that there is a crime that should attract your attention? It is something that shouldn't happen with a non-malicious chat app. What crime it is? Let's see. Okay, we have hide the current apps icon. So I can, this is it. How many classes have a TCP connection and are identified as being part of our malicious activity? So we have to go down a bit, and you can see that in the behavior analysis we have a TCP socket. Click on the eye and you will see 5 classes, which 6 classes actually, which is oki.java, and except that 5 are basically the same. So we can see that how many classes have a TCP connection and identified as being part of a malicious activity. So we can see that 5, because the 5 of them look similar, and there was only 1 which was different, and it is probably not a malicious one. How can we find it? It is not a malicious one. I can show you. Let me just answer this question. Go on Google and click on here. Okay, as you can see, this it is a modern library for Android, Java and Kotlin, which makes it easier to access, store and process your data. So this, we can know that this is not a malicious class. So let's move on to task 4. So in task 4, it will tell you about hunting and, you know, fingerprinting the SSD and Dexo fuzzy results, and we'll see antivirus, most popular antivirus detection, and some Yara rules. So let's start answering the question. In this section, for search by identified names, click on the magnifying glass icon to search by FinSpy samples. Okay, I guess we will have to go to fingerprint here and click on here, find other similar samples. Okay, no, this, that's not it. Threat intel. Okay, yes, it is here. Find similar samples. So now we can simply search here. What did you notice? What What do you notice that will identify your sample as having similarities with the other tab results? Okay, other tab results. Okay, this org.xmlpush.v3 was here as well, so I guess this is it. Click on here and let's move on to task 5. In this we will have to use the search feature. Find the SHA-256 hash of a previous sample and run a query using the hash. Okay, the hash was here. Let's copy it from here. Go to task 5. Click on the website. And we can simply click on this question mark and we can see the attributes through which we can filter. So we are looking for SHA. We are doing a query through SHA-256. So this is SHA-256 colon and the hash. SHA-256 colon and the hash. Click on search and we see our result. So the format is SHA-256 colon the hash. What query would you use to find the non-malicious class? What query would we use? So actually we know that there was a Java class which was used to access and store information, this oki.java. yes, I am right, I think. Let's go to the query option and we can see the filters. We can see that we can filter by Java classes. So we know that there was a non-malicious class which was a Java class. So I guess this is the filter. So let's click on here, search, and I guess it was okio.java. Okay, let's remove the Java. Okay, so let's move on to task 6, which is, now let's recap what we have explored in this room. Firstly, we worked on a trojanized application. So what is trojanized application of wire? It means it looks like a normal application, but it has some malicious content inside it. Maybe a spyware, maybe a malware, virus, anything that is linked to the threat actor FinSpy. At the time this room was created, little public information is available as to where this trojanized application has been used and how many victims have been affected. Nevertheless, we have gathered preliminary knowledge of the application's behavior that could speed up a future in-depth code analysis. We have identified network communication classes that could serve as useful pivot points should you continue to analyzing this sample on your own. So basically, finally, we have played with this some search feature of PitHuss, and which will allow us to look for some samples based on the atomic indicators of compromises. It's time for our journey to come to an end. So let's click on complete here. So that completes our task 6 and our room called Android Malware Analysis. And thank you for watching.